We are with entrepreneur, CEO extraordinaire, Naheed Kurji, the founder and CEO, president of Cyclica. How are you?
Doing excellent. How are you doing?
Great. I thought we'd start by hearing your story, your personal story, as well as the vision and moonshot of Cyclica.
My story to Cyclica is kind of unique in that I joined the company in the early days as VP finance and CFO as we were going through a seed round of financing. And the company was seeded as an idea from our awesome founder, Jason Mitakidis, who I got to know in business school. And as he was going through the formation of the company and raising some money, as scientists, sometimes they need some business acumen to come behind them and build a back office. And so that was my introduction to Cyclica, as the founder brought me alongside him to help build the company. And since then, it's been 4 years, and now I'm CEO of the company, president and CEO, and leading a dynamic team that thinking big and outside of the box on how to make lives easier for scientists so that they can make lives better for us as patients.
So let's dig into that, because I think what you are doing at Cyclica and what the original vision has always been is so extraordinary. Mm-hmm. And actually, it was really kind of ahead of its time when you guys started Cyclica. What is the vision, and how do you describe what you're trying to do?
We call our vision our winning aspiration. And our winning aspiration is to be an integral utility platform in the pharma R&D value chain. We want to bring in technology to scientists so that we can augment their decision making on what drugs to invest their time, knowledge, and resources in. And so our goal as a company is not to just be one tool for one scientist, but to be that utility platform that all scientists rely on every day.
So you guys are using data, mm-hmm. you're using AI in really extraordinary ways to help pharmaceutical companies during their drug discovery and development process?
Yes. So the medicines that you and I take as consumers and patients interact with many aspects of our biology. Some are intended, expected, and understood, and that's awesome. While many others are unintended, unexpected, and not well understood. And we call those off-target interactions. Now, unfortunately, conventional science just isn't good at uncovering these off-target interactions, and many of those can lead to toxic events, adverse events, and as a result, many drugs fail to hit the market, which is not only costly to pharma, but adversely impacts us as consumers and patients and human health in general. And so drugs interact with biological protein targets. But the conventional way of doing computational drug discovery, which has been around since the 1970s, was to find from a library of drugs which ones interact with one biological target. And that's all well and good, but as I just mentioned, there's all these off-target interactions. So the traditional way, which is called virtual screening, which you can think of as taking a library of keys and one lock and finding which keys open up that lock, is only taking scientists so far. So we flipped the problem on its head and we came at it with a different strategy. And that is, we have a city like New York full of doors, and we have multiple keys, give us as many keys as a scientist wants. And we can run those through and show which doors, which proteins interact with that key. And that's critically important because off-target profiling, what we call polypharmacology, is essential in moving drugs forward through the pipeline.
So this, using your technology, your platform, basically can make the entire discovery process more efficient, hopefully save time and money?
Yes. That is our goal. So our cloud-based platform is called Ligand Express. It's an online platform where scientists in a private and secure setting can log into their own proprietary or private Ligand Express portal. They can submit drugs for computational assessment, and they can interact with the data in a elegant, friendly UI, UX viewer in the background that then can guide decisions into the lab. And so we sell it under a software as a service business model. And our goal is to help scientists more efficiently discover safer and more effective medicines.
So wave a magic wand. Your mm-hmm. moonshot as a company, when the whole industry is using Cyclica, what happens?
Yeah, so pharma is facing a litany of challenges. And there's a number of reasons that they're facing these litany of challenges, but the result of all these challenges is that there's a productivity decline. The data is pretty clear that it costs billions of dollars and takes dozens of years, 12 to 15 years, to bring a single drug to the market. And across all big industries, pharma is the one that has not adopted technology to create efficiency gains. And so our moonshot idea is, instead of spending 12, 15 years and $2 to $4 billion to bring a drug to the market, let's aim for $750 million to $1 billion by raising red flags earlier on, failing fast, failing cheap, getting to the clinic the best lead molecules. Because of that $2.65-3 billion for drug development from inception to market, a billion's coming in drug discovery. So if we can cut that down, we can get the best drugs on the market faster, lower cost. And for the pharma companies, they like this because they can extend their patent life cycle on the market and continue to.
You guys have already made extraordinary progress. You're working with J Labs and J&J and many extraordinary institutions. Mm-hmm. Maybe talk a little bit about where you are today.
Yeah, so Cyclica is a product of the institutions, the people that we've surrounded ourselves with. And so we're founded in Toronto. We're a Toronto-based company. We have an office in Cambridge, Massachusetts as well. And from the early days, we were part of the Mars ecosystem in Toronto, which is an incubator, accelerator, a scientific hub. It's a cool place, right on 101 College Street downtown. And importantly, J Labs now has facilities in the Mars building. And so Johnson & Johnson has come in and invested heavily in the Toronto marketplace. And so we've entrenched ourselves there. There's a number of accelerators and incubators that have helped support our growth. And then in 2014, we joined Startup Health, and that was our first venture into the US marketplace. And you guys helped soft land us here in not only New York, but also in the US, providing us guidance, advisory on the steps that we need to take to ensure that we grow methodically and not just throw spaghetti against the wall and hope it sticks. And so we're thankful to all those partners. In September of 2017, after about a year of dialogue with Johnson & Johnson Innovation, we were invited and we applied for kind of access to the J Labs ecosystem, which is a phenomenal network of scientists across disciplines that fit a mandate or a strategy of Johnson & Johnson. And over the past month and a half, the value from them has been incredible, and we're so thankful that we're part of that ecosystem.
That's tremendous. It's such an extraordinary moment too. You know, these buzzwords, digital health, mm-hmm. you know, data is the new oil, precision medicine, get thrown around. What you guys are doing really gets to the center of some of these buzzwords, right? Let's talk about that. Let's talk about how you're leveraging data, AI, and where this goes in the future.
Yeah, that's a really good question, and it's a deep dialogue. There's buzz around AI for drug discovery, something we're passionate about. Cyclica is not an AI company. We are, in scientific lingo, we're a structure-based company that leverages AI to augment some of our analysis. And the difference there is critically important. So as I mentioned, computational drug discovery is nothing new, and I have to shout out the three pillars in the space: R.A. Warshall, Michael Levitt, and Martin Karplis, and many others who laid the foundation of computational modeling back in the 1970s. And their work resulted in them sharing the Nobel Prize in 2013. And over the past 5 to 7 years, with advancements in computational power, rich data sets, access to that data, a number of companies have emerged in the space applying AI to training data to make inferences and predictions to help guide health outcomes. And our view at Cyclica is that while AI will undeniably play an important role in the future of drug discovery, it's only one piece of a much bigger puzzle, like you said. And that our view is that the combination of knowledge-based approaches like AI, machine learning, deep learning, neural networks, and structure-based approaches based on the principles of biophysics, chemoinformatics. Bringing those two together is the solution that scientists are looking for. AI alone will not provide all the answers to the questions, neither will structure-based approaches. And so what we've done is we've brought them together. We are a structure-based company, biophysics, chemoinformatics, and augmented by AI. And we do that in a cloud-based setting. And so the future of AI is bright, but if we also demystify the value, and it's not a solution to all problems,
it's a tool.
It's a tool.
You.
Yeah, exactly.
I think that's really important, and a lot of people get enamored by the buzzwords, but it's really all part of a fabric of an infrastructure that makes it possible to create a new future, new
Absolutely.
Solutions. It's interesting you talk about the scientists from the 70s who mm-hmm. really laid a foundation to get to where we are today, and how you're leveraging that.
Totally.
It takes so much time. What I think is extraordinary is the moment we're in, considering what's happened over the last several decades. It seems to, a lot of it's culminating now over
Absolutely.
The next few years.
The time is right. The time is now. The time is now for computational drug discovery. The time is right for other technologies in healthcare outside of just drug discovery, where you're thinking of AI for patient cohort, where you're thinking of all the advancements that we're seeing in diagnostics and medical devices, and the willingness by physicians, practitioners, scientists to adopt technology. That wave, that tidal wave of science is right here. And at Cyclica, we hope we're leading the charge there, and that we always view a tidal wave of science behind our back. We need to continue to innovate. And importantly, that we stand on the shoulders of giants in the space, as I mentioned before, and a number of other companies that emanated from that science. We have a lot of deference there. So it's a cool period in time. And I think the next 10 years or 10 years from now, when we look back to this era, we're going to say, cool, this advanced science in a drastic way.
You're working with some of the largest companies in the world. We talked about Johnson & Johnson and J-Labs, IBM as well.
Yes.
What's your experience as an entrepreneur, and maybe some of the lessons learned of being a startup, moving quickly, being innovative, coming with new ideas, and also trying to work with some of the largest institutions in the world? Any lessons learned you can share?
Too many for this one discussion. You know, we were humbled by the marketplace, and I'll say that proudly. In the early days of our company, we had a great story. We had a vision and a technology that we thought was certainly unique, and because of that, we thought it was going to quickly be adopted. Couldn't have been farther from the truth. And sometimes as an entrepreneur, you're told you have so much runway, you need to hit milestones, you need to do all these things. But if you take a step back and you put a realistic game plan and keep your head before your feet, and you're methodical and you're patient, and you keep your ear to the ground and listen to what your clients need or what the market needs, that's when you have success. So in April, May 2016, we recalibrated. We had the science and the technology was sound, but our plan to enter the market was flawed. And so we slowed down a little bit. We were told you need to hit all these milestones, and we said, no, let's take a step back. What does the market need for us to then penetrate? Validation, case studies, publications, all these types of what we call the repertoire of marketing material we needed to get, and we need to get in high quality. And so we spent about a year and a half doing that, primarily because we were so humbled from the market on not having that material and them pushing us out of the door. Now we're doing business with the top 20 pharma, massive research institutions globally, pharma companies and global marketplaces, primarily because we slowed down, we did what we needed to do, and then we went back to them.
And this is a long-term vision. You guys have, it's already been several years, but you really have taken a methodical approach about your journey and where you go. How does that play into your decision-making process as a leader, as an entrepreneur?
I think staying nimble, staying flexible, we call it, you know, the Muhammad Ali adage, float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. So we're reactive to what the market is asking for from us, but we're also hyper proactive in being able to set that journey and handhold the market. And so we do it in a collaborative manner. You know, we introspect quite often. Every Tuesday, we have all hands meetings and we have a holistic conversation where we talk about things that are on management's minds and give a voice to the entire company. We're 23 people now, so sometimes people's voices can get lost, to ensure that people's concerns, their excitements can get voiced, and that we're all moving in the same direction in a highly transparent way. And so some of the issues that we faced in the first couple of years that led to us lackluster growth and being challenged in the marketplace, we've adopted into our go-forward plan, and we're just making sure that we never face those issues again, and that we continue just chugging along with the momentum that we have under us now.
Fantastic. Tell me about what you're most excited about.
I'm most excited about 2018 is going to be an exciting year. We've set the stage really hard in 2017 through some key validation, got top 20 pharma companies actively using our technology, coming out behind us, supporting us through anecdotal evidence and case studies, and setting the stage for an exciting 2018 and beyond. I'm most excited about the people. Over the past year, kind of year over year to date, we've expanded by 2.5 times. We now have a fully commercial team. You know, world recognized people in this space have left their other positions and joined Cyclica to help us grow. And that's pretty exciting. Sometimes I sit back and I'm just like, how am I, as a CFO, not a PhD, who found my way into this amazing company, how did we bring all these incredible people together, retain them, and then where we're going in the future? That's pretty exciting.
Absolutely tremendous. Naheed, it's great to have been on this journey with you, continue this journey with you. It's so exciting to see you guys grow and the extraordinary things you're doing that I think are going to make a tremendous impact for the world. So thank you.
Looking
forward to having you at the Startup Health Festival.
Absolutely.
And where can people go to learn more about Cyclica?
You can check our LinkedIn page. We have active press releases, blogs, all that kind of stuff on LinkedIn. Our website, we disseminate our own scientific content. We talk about scientific progress that's happening in the space related to or unrelated to Cyclica. So just interested people in the space can come and just learn. So CyclicaRx.com, have an active Twitter handle, and then just in general, you can call me up. So we have
great
a conversation.
We'll put links in the post.
Perfect.
Thank you for everything you do.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.